welcome to the session on how to work with Google Classroom. So first of all, open your Gmail account and click on the nine dots button or menu on the top right corner and search for Google Classroom. So click on the Google Classroom. So now your Google Classroom will look like this because you have not created any classes yet. So go to the top right corner of your page. You will find a plus symbol here. So click on that. So either you can join a classroom or you can create a classroom. So as a teacher, we need to create a classroom, right? So for that reason, click on create class. So after clicking on create class, you will be getting something like this one. So you can give the names like this. Let us say, suppose the class name is some NNNDL subject, section is 4x4 CSCC, and again the subject is NNNDL. Okay, the room is NNNDL online class. So click on create. So soon after you click on create, your new classroom will be created now. So after clicking on create, your screen will look like this. So it is also asking me to add meeting to my class, so that we will be discussing about how to add the meeting, Google Meetings, to our class later. Okay, so clicking on got it. So this is our home page of our Google Classroom. So next, we have different tabs here. If you see here, the first tab is screen, the second tab is classwork, the third one is people, and the fourth one is grade. So in the stream tab, you can see your home page and you can create your online meeting links and all. Okay, and the main thing which you are going to use is classwork. So when you click on classwork, your the page looks like this. So you have a Google meeting and you have Google calendar, you have class drive folder and all these things. So you have a button here called create. So if you click on create, so there are different options which you can create. That is, you can create an assignment, you can create a quiz assignment, a question, a material, a reuse post, or a topic. So for today's in the session, we will just be discussing about how to create a quiz assignment or simply a quiz. So before creating this, first of all, what we have to do, we have to add the students into our classroom, so that whatever things we do and whatever work we do, all this work will be visible by the students, right? So here you have two different types of things called teachers and students. Okay, so now we have to add our students by clicking on this particular button, that is invite students. So click on this particular one. So let us say I'll be using my another mail ID as a student mail ID. So I'm going to type my mail ID. Okay, so I've got this one. Okay, and then I'm also typing another mail ID. So now I'm clicking on invite. So soon after I click on invite, what actually happens is now. So if you see here, it is telling me error message that can't invite the two students from these domains because I'm working in my anits.edu.in domain, but I'm inviting the email IDs which are out of the domain. So what we should do is that we can only invite the people from the anits domain. So if you wanted to invite the people from the other domain or any other students who are not in your anits domain, you just simply can go to your home page and you can generate your meeting link. So you can simply generate the meeting link. So if you click on the generate the meeting link, okay, so see, I am going to click on the generate meeting link. The meeting link will be generated. So this is the meeting link. Okay, so this meeting link you can copy in any copy or share through any of the platforms like WhatsApp or through Gmail. Okay, if any other student did not get any invite link of your particular classroom, so you can copy this and send it to him, so that the people outside the domain can also access our resources. Okay, so now this is saving. So this is our meeting link. So now I'm going to classwork and then this is the people, right? So I'm going to add the mail ID now. As you see, I'm going to copy paste this Anit's email. So simply you have Anit's email here. So click on invite. So if you click on invite, automatically what happens is that this invite link will be going to that particular student here. So in bracket, you have got something called invited. So if you see here, our invitation link has been received by this particular student. So now the student will open this particular email and he will click on join. So whenever he clicks on join, now it is going to take him to this particular classroom. So the students can now pick their role because they are the student. They are clicking on I am a student. So their home page looks like this. So they also have the stream option, classwork option, and people option also. Okay. So this is their home page. So under teacher, you will be getting the teacher's email ID. So now this is the home page of the student. So now coming back to the teacher's page again. So I'm going to click on classwork. So first of all, we'll see in this session how to create a quiz here. So click on quiz. So now your quiz console will be opening. So you can give the title of the quiz. That is quiz 1. Let us say this is quiz 1. So you can give the instructions of the quiz. Those are optional, optional, or you can give the instructions so that each question carries 1 mark and you have to complete so and so. It is compulsory or something. Okay. So what you can do here is, you have a blank quiz here. So if you click on the blank quiz, so now it is being redirected to the blank quiz. Okay. So now if you see here, so now you see here the blank quiz, or you can rename it to some quiz one. You can give the form description also. And now the first you have first untitled question. That is, if you wanted to add a particular question, you can add. So who or what is NN? Okay. So the first option is option 1, neural networks, and you can click here so that you can add another option, and then you can add third option, networks. So like this, you can add different options. You have different types of questions also here, whether it is short answer or paragraph or multiple choice or checkbox. For this time, I am going to tell about multiple choice question. So this is our model. If you wanted to remove this particular option, you can click on this cross button. And if you wanted to add a particular image, sometimes your question contains an image, right? So options also contains an image. So if you wanted to add an image in the question, you click here. So you can upload a particular image. You can insert or upload the image by clicking on browse, and you can go to the my computer. Okay. So from here, you can click on a particular one, and you can click on a particular one, and you can click on open. Okay, so this is how you can insert the image here. Okay, for options also you can add images here by clicking on this one. And the next one, the thing is that if this is the required question, so obviously you have to switch on the toggle button here. So that is, this function, this question is required. That is, without attempting this question, the student cannot click on submit button. And next, you have something called answer key and points. Okay. So click on answer key and points. So what actually happens is, you have to write the total number of marks for this particular question, and you have to give the correct answer. So let us say if you wanted to give 1 mark for this question, so you click on 1, and also you have to select the correct answer. So what is the correct answer? Let us say neural networks is the correct answer. So this is the correct answer. And you can also add the feedback for your answer. That is, you can give the explanation so that you need not explain it again. So the correct answer. So the correct answer's feedback is here. Incorrect answer. If the student submits an incorrect answer, it will be given the feedback for that incorrect answer. If you incorrect answers or correct answers, you can give the feedback here. If the student under incorrect answer, simply give NN is defined as neural networks. Okay. So simply, if you wanted to add the supporting link here, okay, you can add the supporting link, or you can add the supporting video also here, so that student can be able to see the correct answers explanation here. Okay, so these are all the different kinds of things. So this is the correct answer feedback here. You can add the same thing. So you can click on save. So when you click on save, what actually happens? Now you will be getting like this. So after you done editing your question, now you have to click on done. Okay. So after clicking on done, it again returns you back to this question. So if you wanted to add a new question, again click on the plus button. So simply now you will be getting the second question. So what is DL? Okay, so option 1 is something called deep learning, and option 2 is something called DL. Okay, so this is also another multiple choice question. So simply I'm going to assign. So this is also a required one. So now I'm going to again give the answer key here. Answer key is deep learning. Again, the points are 1 point. So you can add the answer feedback, and you can click on done. So these are the two questions now which I have given. So the total points here are 2 points. So you can also do some more editings on this one. That is, you can add the description here. So if you wanted to add the description here, so you can add the description. So it will be asking you about the description of this particular question. Or if you wanted to shuffle the options of the options order, that is, for one question it will be the first option is deep learning and second option is DL. For another student it will be the first option is DL and the second option is deep learning. So like this, the options can also be shuffled for the students. So after doing these two questions, now I'm going to click on send here. So when I click on send, now I'm going to send it via either email or send it via any link or something. So you can send it by entering the email and then you can click on send. So but the thing is that we don't want to send from here, we just wanted to send from our classwork because we have already added some students here, right? So do remember that you have to make sure that you have to switch on this toggle button for grade importing. If you do not turn on the grade importing, so the grades of the students will not be imported into your sheets. Okay, so this is the quiz one. Now we have done editing, so now you click on assign. So whenever you click on assign, now the quiz is being assigned to all the students which you have invited. So this will be looking like this. Okay, so now we'll see whether the student has got this particular quiz or not. So you see now, so when I have refreshed, now the student's screen can be seen here. So now he has got the new assignment which the teacher has created. So he can click on this particular one and he can attempt this one. Okay, so he can click on this quiz one. Okay, now he can attempt this particular quiz. Okay, so now this is the one. Okay, so now what is NN, something called neural networks, and what is DL or something. Okay, he clicks on submit. So whenever he clicks on submit, so he can view the score also. Okay, if he click on view score, so he can see the score. So this is one by one, that is, he has given the correct answer. See, whether correct answer or wrong answer, we can give the feedback here. That is, NN is defined as neural network. So what is DL? Actual answer is deep learning, but he has given DL. So if you can, if you wanted to give a feedback here, so you can also give the feedback here. So now let's go to the teacher's console. So you see, this is the teacher's console. Now you click on this particular quiz. So it is showing us that for quiz one, turned in are total number of people are 1 and assigned are 0. That is, the turned in means, so you have assigned a quiz to only one person because we have invited only one person and that one person has attempted the quiz, and there are no other people which are left for writing the quiz. So that is the reason it is showing 0. So now we have this one here. So now you can import the grades of students by clicking on this import grades button. So it is asking whether you are sure you wanted to import the grades. So click on import and it is importing the grades here. So you can see here, after importing the grades, after importing the grades, he has got 1 mark out of 2 marks, because you know that we saw he has only attempted only 1 correct answer out of 2 correct 2 answers. So there will be, if there are more number of students, so he wanted to return the grades to the students. So then click on all students. That is, if you add all the group mail, if you add the group mail ID, so that all the students will be selected here, and you click on return. So now the marks will be notified to the student, and if you wanted to write any comment, you can write the comment for that particular student and click on return. So now you see that now the you have graded this particular student. So this is the graded students information. So this is our homepage again. So if you wanted to see the grades of the students or of all the quizzes, so click on this grades tab. So here you will be having, this is quiz 1. So if you have conducted quiz 2, it will be coming here, quiz 3, quiz 4 and so on. So you can see all the marks of this particular student. See here, this particular student has got 1 mark out of 2 marks. So when the student has done the responses, you can see that here. So these are the questions and these are the responses. That is, one student has responded. So you can see that one, that is, you can get the complete details of your class students who have responded for this one. So this is the email of the student who has responded, and this is his score. Okay, so you can get all the details of your particular quiz also here. So after some particular time, so if you don't want to allow the students to generate their responses, or if you don't want your students to submit the quiz, so simply you toggle the button called accepting responses. So simply deactivate this one. So from now, the Google Sheet or the quiz will not be accepted from the student's end. So now you can see here, if the student wanted to answer the quiz, he will be clicking on this particular link. So now what it is saying, the form fusion is no longer accepting responses. Okay, so because we have turned off our responses by the students, so the students cannot answer this particular quiz now. Also, another thing is that if you wanted to add people, as we already discussed, you go to the people and you can click on this one and you can invite this one. Okay, so I have already added another person also. He has been invited. You can see the observe between the colors. It is dark black color, this is gray color. So the people who have opened your invite link and you have done some work, then they will be given in the dark color, and this particular person has not opened our invite link. So this is, that is the reason it is showing in the gray color. So as I have also sent the invite link to this particular student, so let us see whether this student has received the invite link or not. So if you see, this particular student did not receive any invite link in the primary tab. So students may be using different types of tabs. Okay, so please ask them to see all the tabs. So here in this particular updates tab, so now he has got this particular Google invite link. So when he click on join, now he will be joining into this particular Google Classroom. So the student, after opening this, he may get the options like this, decline and join. So make sure that they click on join. Okay, so after clicking on join, now he will be able to see all the things which you have kept as part of our teacher's homepage. Okay, so now as I have added the quiz in my teacher's homepage, okay, he will be getting this one. Okay, so now he can attempt the quiz here. So the same thing he can do here. So he can attempt the quiz here. So now he has given another answers for this one. Okay, and he is clicking on submit. Okay, now he can view the score here. So we can view the score. Okay, he has got 0/2 marks, because he has given all the wrong answers. So now you can see here, now you have two responses which have been responded here. Okay, so now so these are the questions which you have given. These are the two responses from the two different students. Okay, so these are the two responses given by the two students. So in this manner you will be getting all the responses in this particular quiz. So now again you can go to your teacher's homepage and you click on grades. So now you'll be getting the another student grades also here. Okay, so now this is the first student. You can see that this particular student has resubmitted, because I resubmitted this particular quiz of this student again. So that is the reason we are getting this one. So now we got the quiz grade of this particular student here. So even though the student has submitted, the second student has submitted the quiz, we do not get any grades here. Why? Because we do not import the grades. So to import the grades, again you have to go to the quiz. Okay, so now you see here, you click on import the grades. So the grades will be imported here. Okay, after importing, then you will be getting all the grades. Okay, so after importing grades, again go to the home page. Now you see the grades here. So now you will see that your grades will be given here. See, now you have got the grades, because it is 0/2, because he has given all the wrong answers. So this is how you have to import the grades, and then you can see the grades here. So if you wanted to download the grades in Excel sheet, then you can also click here and you click on download these grades as CSV, or download all grades as CSV. So simply downloading these grades as CSV means now a CSV file will be downloaded, so that you can view them in your Google Sheet. So if you open this one, and now all the students who have entered your information, entered the quiz information, will be given here. So their last name, first name, email address, and then the grades will be also be given here. That is grade, this is 1 for this particular person. The grade is 0 because he did not enter anything. So these assignments are done. So any comments if you have given, then they will be visible here. So as a last thing is that see, the previously it is in gray color, now it has been turned into black color. So because the other student has also joined into this particular Google Classroom. Okay, so this is all about the basic information about Google Classroom and how you can create a quiz in Google Classroom. So in the next session we'll be discussing with the other topic.